was he like?
Who?
My dad.
Your dad was... He was great.
You met at school?
Mm-hmm. We became aware of each other when we were about 17. He had mixed with other boys before that. Different crowd than what I was used to hang out with. Actually, we come into contact a few years before in a school play. One of those mystery things, the creation. He was the serpent.
What were you?
I was Eve.
How'd you manage that?
Well, I was in a flesh-colored body stocking with a fig leaf. But we didn't really have that much to do with each other. I think he always thought that I was a bit of a poof. Well, in fact, I know he did because he was always telling me, I think you are a bit of a poof, aren't you? But I didn't really mind because I know that he was at that age when boys can be just like that. A few years later, with puberty and everything, but he was really nice to me. Really nice. And we became mates. It was music. He was a very good musician.
I know.
Truly gifted. One time he arranged a whole concert. Lots of people were involved. And he was playing some fantastic stuff. But I will always remember. He got a couple of travels, really quite young, to sing this duet by Monteverdi. It was most inappropriate lyrics-wise. But that was Sherry for you, always chancing his arm.
Why was it inappropriate?
Because they were declaring undying love to each other, but they were only 11. Still, there were no complaints, probably because he was in Italian. But it was an exquisite moment, too. These few voices singing with Jerry on the piano. I think it's the only time I saw him lost for words.
Don't you ever feel like you could raise yourself even a few inches off the ground and glide away?
To be honest, no.
Did your dad ever take drugs?
No.
Didn't you?
Well, not that I remember.
You look like you did.
What do you mean?
The picture.
Oh. Well, we might have had a little of something or other.
Would you like a little something or other now?
What are you talking about?
Would you like a little something now?
I don't even know
this
what
this guy, it's cool. He's always got a little something or other. I think he's one of Lord Charlotte's sons.
Well,
would you like some?
I don't think you should. What is it?
Coke.
Oh, well, then definitely you shouldn't be doing any of this. You shouldn't be doing anything. You shouldn't be smoking, for goodness sake.
Would you like some?
Well... You know, it's so good to see you without a lump on your head. Oh, I'm sorry. God.
What?
Well, you used to have one as a baby. You didn't know?
No.
Didn't you? Well, Jerry thought that you were from another planet and that was an implanted radio to receive messages from your mothership.
I don't think I've ever seen photographs of me as a baby.
I'm sorry.
What happened to it?
Well, it went. It went away, apparently of its own accord. I think that these things just come and go. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say it, really. I'm so sorry, sometimes I'm really stupid and...
No problem.
Well, that was the last time I saw Jerry.
When?
Your christening. Which was the first time I saw you. We had such a great time together. Your dad and me. And when we were younger, well, your dad was... He was everything that mattered to me. He was everything good and happy in my life at that time. But all of that is gone, just like him. Ah. There was one day we had just one day, when I met your mother, actually, which was sort of complete, one of those moments in life when you realize that's what it's like to be happy. I begged and hoped there'd be more days like that, but there weren't. There weren't. Not quite like that. Anyway, when I'm dying, I know it's that moment that'll make me think that everything was worthwhile. Everything. My entire life. Everything. All my life crystallized in the memory of that moment. It was like we were outside time. It's not a minute. It's a mystery. I think a moment it's part of the mystery of life.
You're not dying, are you?
Oh no.
Are you?
No, I'm perfectly well.
You're not ill.
I'm perfectly well. What did you ask?
Have you got a note?
What?
Now they got a scratched up fire.
Oh. Right. Do you need some?
No.
I mean,
no.
Apart from. Are you sure?
Well, I suppose an odd spare quid could always come in handy.
Here, keep it.
No.
It's yours.
Brilliant.
You know, actually I've had that before. Once. In the museum basement with an Egyptologist.
Did you like it?
I like the Egyptologist.
Train of cocaine.
What do you mean?
Four lines.
Oh. Pretty good.
So, Horace,
mm-hmm.
You don't mind me calling you that, do you?
Mm-mm. It's my name.
I know. Horace.
Oh, dear, not again.
Horace.
Isn't it too cold for this?
Wouldn't it be great to fly?
Shh! Jimmy, not too loud.
Just take off.
Shh.
And fucking fly!
Is this the coke talking?
I've always wanted to fly.
Jimmy, relax.
Look at the moon, Horace. What a lovely fucking moon.
Yes.
The mooniest fucking moon I ever did see.
What are you saying?
Oh, this is great, Boris. Come on, let's have another drink.
Yeah. You really must have got your cold. Jimmy. Let's go this way.
Let's have another drink. Planet, Horace!
God. Why am I so tense with them? Why?
I want to be part of a planetary system.
Jeez.
I want to make history, Horace!
Here, help yourself.
I want something to fight for, Horace.
You want, one.
Don't you, Horace? Don't you want something to fight for?
Well, you don't have to keep saying my name.
and something to believe in. Wouldn't it be great, Horace? And someone. Someone to believe in. That's the thing, Horace, isn't it? To have someone to grow strong with. They don't always let you down, do they?
Let's go inside. Let's go inside.